what they say can't be done. We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm East Carter's Quadro Bandit Club. Keep the foot on the pedal, some hell of a minding break. Let it all hang out, cause we got a run to make. The boys are first dip in Atlanta, and they're here in Texarkana, and we'll bring it back no matter what it takes. They say can't be done. We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound to Quattro Bandit Run. Old Smokey got them ears on. He's not on your trail. You gotta keep that diesel trucking. Just put that hammer down and get it here. Eastbound and down, loaded up and trucking. Are we gonna do what they say can't be done? We've got a long way to go and a short time to get there. I'm eastbound to watch our bandit run.
On Central, re-enter the real hero. Clyde the orangutan and Mr. Clint Eastwood proving once again that it's all every which way but loose. An hilarious film classic with Clyde the megastar, Clyde the superhero, Clyde the sloppy kisser. Clyde and Clint Eastwood in every which way but loose.
Bang.
Monday fun at 10:30 on Central.
That must have been a good day off.
Kellogg's Rice Krispies, the only ones with snap, crackle and pop.
The 1986 Volvo 340 is as tough and reliable as ever. But now it's a saloon as well as a hatchback. And it comes with the option of a new, bigger 1.7-litre engine. For those who appreciate a little more power.
Nice to hear they're settling in. It must be strange. Well, Australia's not exactly Luton. I suppose the food's all different over there. No birds trifle. It's Peter's favourite.
Your family's never far away when birds trifle's on the table.
New Braun System 123. Position 1, the platinum-plated foil for closer shaving. Position 2, the trimmer cuts longer hairs, then the foil polishes them off. Position 3, for precise trimming. The new Braun. Closer than your current shaver, or your money back.
A wonderful way to keep your lavatory clean and fresh always. New Frish Lavatory Freshener. At every flush, you release its fresh fragrance and cleaning foam to help keep your lavatory clean and fresh. For freshness in your lavatory always, new Frish Lavatory Freshener.
The Power Shower. It does everything you want it to. It gives you the control to suit your mood. To pamper, to soothe your cares away. Or invigorate, to leave you feeling tingling fresh. Added to your gas central heating, its powerful pump maintains the temperature you choose and keeps the luxurious flow constant. The Power Shower. Now a shower with real power. From British Gas.
I taste sensation from Del Monte. Cool, refreshing island blend. Naturally refreshing, served ice cold. Cool, refreshing island blend. Citrus juices with pineapple. Cool, refreshing island blend. The real fruit kind to quench your
Cool Refreshing Island Blend.
Cool Refreshing Island Blends from Del Monte.
Sunday, wrote Mr. Kipling, and whilst sharing my exceedingly famous Bakewell tart, I remembered how, as a small boy, I had longed for a whole Bakewell all for myself. That night, my idea took shape. An individual Bakewell filled with jam. Rich frangipan, iced, and topped with cherry. Cherry Bakewells, far too good for small boys.
Learn to swim. Ask for details at your local swimming baths.
He came back from lunch to find all his colleagues shot dead. Now he's on the run. Robert Redford is the Condor. Faye Dunaway, his unwilling accomplice.
People are trying to kill me. I don't know.
Yo!
We have games.
That's right.
We play games.
This is a major, and the section's been hit.
What level?
Everybody.
I don't think you're going to live much longer.
3 days of the Condor, Wednesday at 10:30 on Central.
You're watching Central, and if you've got a copy of the TV Times, we're following Pattern B, which means that the World Cup coverage will begin at 10:45, and Love and Marriage is in a quarter of an hour, right after the latest news from ITN.
Durban car bomb kills three, the ANC are blamed. 12 are hurt as Glasgow to London Express is derailed. Britain's Nigel Mansell wins Canadian Grand Prix. And some late news, summer has arrived. Good evening. The nationwide strike in South Africa, called to mark the 10th anniversary of the Soweto riots, is due to start in a few hours' time, with the country braced for a new outbreak of violence. The strike has been called by the black nationalist organisation the ANC, which was blamed today by the Pretoria government for the car bomb which killed three people overnight. The government condemned the attack in Durban as terrorism of the worst kind, an act of desperation by cowards. Two white women and an Indian woman died when the bomb went off outside a restaurant in the city's main boulevard. Seven blacks died overnight, according to the South African Information Bureau, making 22 dead since the state of emergency started. This report from Peter Sharp has been compiled under the emergency restrictions imposed by the government there.
This was Durban's Golden Mile just moments after the car bomb exploded. Packed with over 100 pounds of plastic explosive, the vehicle had been parked right in front of two popular seafront hotels. It went off without warning. At dawn, the full extent of the damage became clear. The hotel bars and restaurants had been filled with Saturday night diners. It was, said police, a miracle that more people weren't killed. This was a soft target with no possible security force connections. A single flower at the entrance of the hotel marked the place where one young girl was killed.
Well, I was knocked down to the ground, and a few seconds later I came around and I crawled out of the mess.
Eventually I came to and realised that I could actually move my limbs and I was alive, and I was really grateful, and I thought of my young son. And I thought the second thing I thought about was another bomb, and I thought I must get out of here.
The government said the attack appeared to be the work of the ANC.
This indiscriminate action was directed at innocent civilians. The terrorist's aim is to create panic. The people of South Africa refuse to be intimidated and must remain calm and determined.
And South Africa's foreign minister last night warning there'd be no let-up in the war against the ANC.
And irrespective of the international consequences, we have decided to accept poverty, a lowering of standards. We have decided we will not be untrue to our forefathers, to our beliefs, to our values. Come what may, we will resist these by diabolical forces. It doesn't matter what is the cost.
Bishop Tutu held his first church service under the state of emergency at Everton Township outside Johannesburg this morning. Our cameras unable to film the large security force presence that surrounded the church. The Peace Prize winner appealing to blacks to mark the 10th anniversary of the Soweto riots tomorrow with dignity. Given the highly charged atmosphere of the townships under a state of emergency, Bishop Tutu's prayers for peace tomorrow unlikely to be answered. Peter Sharp, ITN in South Africa.
Commonwealth leaders tonight put Mrs. Thatcher under strong pressure to change her stand on sanctions against South Africa. Dr. Robert Mugabe of Zimbabwe attacked her for blacking sanctions and told a huge rally in Harare that a new African defence force should be set up to topple the South African government.
I cannot see South Africa's regime, the South African regime, defeat an African force that is well armed.
President Kaunda of Zambia has given Mrs. Thatcher until August to bring in sanctions before he decides whether to act on his threat to pull out of the Commonwealth. And the Australian Prime Minister, Mr. Bob Hawke, said Mrs. Thatcher was risking the future of the Commonwealth by insisting she was right and everyone else was wrong. A Glasgow to London express train has been derailed in Scotland and 12 people have been hurt. The train went off the track at Motherwell station and one coach crashed into the platform.
British Rail still don't know what caused the derailment. The Intercity 125 Express was on a routine run from Glasgow to London and not scheduled to stop before Carlisle. As it sped through Motherwell station at around 60 miles an hour, the six rear carriages broke free and fell off the rails, coming to rest against the platform. Passengers later said that as soon as the train had entered the station, it began to jump up and down, and as it toppled over, stones and dust came crashing in through the windows. The 12 injured were taken to Law Hospital outside Motherwell. Two are still detained tonight, including one who is reported to have suffered a heart attack. British Rail say they will hold a full public inquiry, and their own internal investigation into the cause of the accident will start first thing in the morning.
A Danish powerboat racer has been killed in the World Championships at Bristol City Docks. Jürgen Asker died after his 2-litre boat crashed onto a pier. His brother Klaus, who was also taking part, abandoned the race and tried to save him. It's the fifth fatal accident in the 15-year history of the event. The Soviet authorities have sacked two top managers for negligence at the Chernobyl nuclear plant. A report in Pravda said they failed to provide firm leadership and discipline. It's the first punishment of senior officials since the accident in April, which has so far claimed 26 lives. In Israel, the main synagogue in Tel Aviv has been ransacked by a group protesting against ultra-Orthodox Jews. They daub swastikas and anti-religious...